morning, everyone. Let's pray together before worship. Let's put our hands together and close our eyes. Dear Lord, thank you for the new day that you've given us. We come to you to hear your words and get to know you more. Please protect us from all the dangerous things of this world and provide us with all the things that we need. Thank you, Lord. We love you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Hi guys! Did you guys learn alphabet? A, B, C, D? Yeah? Okay, I have two different words here. They look similar, but they have opposite meanings. Take a look. This is kind. Repeat after me. Kind. And this is unkind. What is kind? Being kind or kindness is being friendly, being generous, or being nice to others. Unkind, of course, is not being kind. Okay, I have some pictures here. So, which one is kind? Okay, is she kind? Yes, she is kind. What about this? Is he kind? No, he is unkind. What about this one? Is she kind? Yes, she is kind. Do you think God is kind? Yes, God is so kind. And God wants us to show kindness to one another or to others. In today's Bible story, we hear how King David showed kindness to someone from King Saul's family. Okay, put on thinking caps and listening ears and gentle heart. What's the story?
David was a good king for God's people. He won battles against his enemies, and God helped him do what was fair and right for the Israelites. One day, David thought about King Saul and his family. David and Saul's son Jonathan had been best friends. He had promised to be kind to Jonathan's family. David wondered if anyone from that family was still alive. David asked one of Saul's servants if anyone was still alive. "I want to show kindness to someone from Saul's family," he explained. "Yes," said the servant. "Jonathan's son, the one who cannot walk, is still alive." Jonathan's son was named Mephibosheth. David called for him to come to Jerusalem. When Mephibosheth got there, he bowed down before David. "Mephibosheth," David said, "don't be afraid. I made a promise to your father, Jonathan, and I want to show kindness to you." David told Mephibosheth what he would do for him. "I will give you all the land that belonged to your grandfather Saul, and I want you to eat all your meals at my table." "Why would you show such kindness to someone like me?" Mephibosheth wondered. David told some servants to take care of the land and farm it for Mephibosheth. From that time on, Mephibosheth lived at the palace and ate his meals at King David's table as if he were one of King David's own sons.
We have been talking about the kings of Israel. Who was the first king of Israel? Yes, King Saul. After he died, David finally became king, the second king of Israel. He was a good king. He loved God so much and obeyed him. And God was with David and helped him to win the battles and do what was right and fair for the people of Israel. One day, King David thought about his best friend, Jonathan, and he remembered that he made the promise with Jonathan to be kind to his family. He wanted to show the kindness of God to King Saul's family, Jonathan's family. And he heard about Mephibosheth. He was the son of Jonathan and grandson of King Saul, but he was not able to walk. But King David called for him to come to Jerusalem. But Mephibosheth was kind of afraid. He was scared because he knew that his grandfather, King Saul, tried to hurt David. But David said, "Do not be afraid. I just want to show kindness to you. I want to give everything that belonged to King Saul, your grandfather, and I want you to eat at my table. So Mephibosheth lived in Jerusalem, and he ate his meals at the king's table as one of the king's sons. The story comes from 2 Samuel chapter 9 in the Old Testament. Think about David and King Saul. King Saul was jealous of David and tried to kill him. So David had to hide in the desert and had a really hard time in the desert for many years. So it was not easy for King David to be kind to Saul's family. However, King David showed kindness to Mephibosheth, King Saul's grandson. Because King David loved God so much, and he knew that God wanted him to show kindness to Saul's grandson. The kindness King David showed to Saul's grandson was from God, not from King David. King David said, I may show the kindness of God, right? So the kindness King David showed was from God. God is kind. God showed us, you know, the amazing kindness. He showed the amazing kindness to us. Jesus. Yes, Jesus died on the cross to save us and to make us God's children. That was amazing kindness God showed us. Yes, now, because Jesus died on the cross, because Jesus showed the amazing kindness on the cross, we are now the children of God. So we have to follow God, and we have to be like Jesus. God wants us to show kindness to others, to one another, as Jesus did, and as David did. God wants us to show kindness to others. We can show kindness to others by telling them about Jesus, sharing our things with them, and helping people who are poor or sick. God wants us to show kindness to others. Okay, let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you so much for teaching about God's kindness and the story about David. Yes, we want to show kindness to others. We want to show the kindness of Jesus by telling people about him and sharing our things and caring for people who are sick or people who are weak. So please help us to be kind always. Please help us to think about Jesus. And please help us to think about all the stories you've given us in the Bible. Thank you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Okay, let's do the memory verse. We have a new memory verse today. Okay, teacher Sophia will teach you.
Today's memory verse is Psalms 145, verse 13. Are you ready? Let's get started. The Lord is faithful in all his words and gracious in all his actions. One more time. The Lord is faithful in all his words and gracious in all his actions. One more time. The Lord is faithful in all his words and gracious in all his actions. Good job, everyone!
Thanks for joining today. I hope you guys enjoyed today's lesson about kindness, and I hope and pray that you can show the kindness of God to others, to one another, to your family and friends. Okay, it's getting hot and humid, so please drink a lot of water. Okay, stay strong and stay healthy. I will see you next Sunday. Bye-bye.